please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Gurdeep Singh, Chairman Managing Director of NTPC, joins us now. Good morning, Mr. Singh. Thanks much. What's the situation at your own New Delhi supplying plants? How long will it last? And would you agree things are critical?
Good morning, Lata. First of all, let me assure you that the power supply, not only to Delhi, but any consumer is... are you able to hear me?
Yes, please go ahead.
Okay. Yeah. It's not only Delhi, the power supply to any part of the country is ample and in abundance. Mm-hmm. So there should not be any worry as far as the power supply or the power availability is concerned. Mm-hmm. So there should not be any concern whatsoever.
No, not the larger... Mr. Singh, not the larger supply issue.
Let me just explain here.
Sure.
We are at present also, we have something like unrequisitioned supply as we are speaking. Mm-hmm. We have sufficient supply. And even there has been backing down on the power stations. And now the rain setting in, I think the power demand is not going to increase so sharply. Mm-hmm. And the power situation in the country is met by the merit order. So it's always better to utilize the cheapest power first. Mm. Having said that, there is no concern as of now. We have more than around 68,000 of coal stock in Dadri also, what you had been mentioning. Mm. So what I would like to assure you is that it's not a power supply is not at all a concern.
So I'll just read this number to you and you tell me if it's right. As of May 2018, 15.7 gigawatts of capacity across 8 of your plants had inventory of less than a week. And again, as of May, 4 plants did not have more than a day's stock. So I'm asking you again, at least in four plants or five plants, a handful of plants, is there a problem of you having to go into lower PLFs?
No, there has been Jane, some concerns on the coal stock level as of now, but there is no problem as far as the power supply is concerned.
Okay.
So, in terms of a coal shortage for the sector as a whole, what is the concern currently? I mean, is it only for Delhi or is it spread out to other geographies as well? And how long do you think it could take for the situation to ease?
No, let me just explain again. Yeah. As of today, we have around 6.5 million ton of coal stock, which is equivalent to almost around 12 to 13 days.
Okay.
Having said that, there are some power stations where there is a coal stock which is relatively less, and there are power stations where it is very, very comfortable. Mm. Now, as the one grid, the one nation, one grid, the power can be supplied from anywhere to anywhere.
Okay.
And fortunately, the power station where it is the cheapest, we have sufficient coal stock.
Okay. Mm.
And that is the most beneficial situation to the consumer.
Okay. That's good to hear, sir, that, you know, if because of the grid, you will be able to supply from surplus areas to areas where there could be a coal shortage. That's reassuring.
And there is no problem in Dadri. There is no problem in Dadri. We have almost 68,000 tons of coal as of now.
Okay. No, the Delhi, Satyendar Jain is interested in Dadri. We are interested in the nation. So we just want to know whether there'll be a coal shortage anywhere. And your point is that, you know, you have an average 12 to 13 and you will be able to supply from surplus plants to the deficit areas, right?
Lata, this good news is that the power consumption is increasing at a very fast rate. Mm. And this is registering almost about 6% growth. And as far as NTPC is concerned, we are registering almost 8% growth. Okay. Last year, let me share with you, last year, the first quarter was almost no growth in comparison to the previous year. Mm. This year, we have registered almost approximately 8% growth.
Okay.
So that is a very, very healthy sign.
Okay. Are you still...
And what we are getting messages is that even the industry consumption has started going up.
Yeah.
And with the help of the Sobhagya and... the earlier than Uday, I think many of the companies which were the discoms which were struggling, they have also become comfortable.
No, that is exactly what I was.
Consumption increase is a very healthy indicator.
Sir, consumption of the consumers has always been increasing. It's the discoms that have been the bottleneck. Can you give us any update on whether more PPAs have been signed medium term? even 1 year, 2 year PPAs, are you seeing any trend?
See, I think again we are going in some of the fundamentals which we should be looking differently when we are talking to NTPC.
Okay.
We are not here for 1 year or 2 year PPAs. We are bound to supply the reliable and affordable power to the consumers. And as of now, we are even constructing the 20 gigawatt power plants. And our PLF has been almost at the same level, although we are adding 4 to 5,000 megawatt of capacity.
Are you constructing fresh thermal capacity, sir? Should you not be stopping it? We have excess thermal capacity.
At present, there is 20 gigawatt under construction. The power plant, the thermal power plant, typically takes around 7 to 8 years. This will be premature to say that you don't require any of the thermal power plant going forward.
So it's
what I'm talking about is the power plant which are under construction. And if the demand is going at a rate of 8%, you will very soon see that we will have to start seeing that we'll have to add additional capacity. Although we'll have to add disproportionately high in case of renewables.
Yes.
But we will require balancing power.
No,
capacity, it's not that you will be only relying on the renewable in the foreseeable future. In the long term, who knows that only renewable will be able to meet. But in the coming future, we have to have the coal-based definite, otherwise we will start facing the problem in the power supply.
Okay. Also wanted your thoughts on the draft tariff regulation that, the proposal to split the tariff into three parts. If this does take place, then how do you think it would impact your own earnings?
See, this is too early to say anything. There is a draft paper, as you rightly said, which has come. We are studying it and there are discussions which are going on. We will be submitting our comments by 15th of July, what has been asked by Honorable Commission. And we should not have any concern because we are in a kind of the cost plus regime where the capacity is contracted. And it has to be seen that there is a healthy returns. Otherwise, meeting the requirement in future will be concerned because there is lot of investment which is required in the sector going forward also.
Okay. Well, Mr. Singh, a final question to you. Has the Sunil Mehta committee contacted you? I mean, the chairman of PNB, he has been tasked with setting up an AMC into which some of the power loans could be moved, some of the power companies, and they may look for someone to operate those power companies. So with respect to distressed power assets, are you a buyer in any of the ones that will come to NCLT, or have you been asked by the Sunil Mehta committee to act as a manager of distressed assets?
See, we had been saying almost more than 6 months that we will be more than happy to take care of any of the asset.
Okay.
For operation maintenance, even if there is some asset which is incomplete and it requires the completion of that, we will be more than happy to help in that. As of now, we don't have any concrete suggestion or any concrete proposal from any corner.
Okay.
Although we are discussing with our REC and PFC,
yes,
but we are very open to take care of the assets as and when it is brought to us.
But that REC, PFC,
and as far as the NCLT is concerned,
yeah, please go ahead, sir.
Go ahead.
Yes.
No, as far as the NCLT is concerned, we have evaluated few of the power stations. If it really makes sense, we will be looking at those assets as and when it is viable.
Are they listed companies?
I'll not be able to comment anything on that.
Okay. And this REC, PFC, SPV that they were talking about, is that progressing at all?
Yeah, I think this is all the three things are going together, like the SBI Samadhan,
yes,
and REC Privartan. These things are going as of now. So as and when there is something concrete, I think you will be the person who will be coming to know as much as I will come to know.
Okay. We hope we'll get that, be able to break that news to you. Thank you very much, sir, for joining us.